Armando, mucho gusto. Yo soy Miguel.
Y también soy
Miguel. Y Miguel Junior.
¿Cómo estás?
Ah, ¿es tu hijo?
Los dos son mis hijos.
Gracias.
Jorge.
Jorge.
Great, nice to meet you again.
Yeah. We met up with Jorge, who's the owner of Macienda, which is a company fighting to promote the indigenous corn coming from Mexico. Through Jorge, we met Armando and his family, who are local corn growers. They've made the growing of indigenous corn their way of life. And Armando explained to us the efforts that he's had to make to protect the corn that he's growing and the culture of growing corn.
Mire, yo siembro aquí este maíz, Jorge, porque se da muy puro.
Pure.
Como no hay contaminación,
sigue
conservando la pureza.
Yeah, it's all blue. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Lo importante es que, mira, aquí no hay polinización de ningún lado. No se poliniza. Por ejemplo, el polen de esa milpa no se puede venir para acá porque está ahí abajo. Entonces, por eso le decía ahorita que este está bien puro ahorita. Uh-huh. Y de aquí pienso sacar semilla de este terrenito. Por eso lo he dejado y no lo he venido a cosechar. Porque pienso sacar semilla para sembrar más. Volver a sembrar otra vez con esta misma semilla y se va haciendo la pureza.
Which is an important distinction because hybrids, you can't really replant them. You have to keep buying every single
buying
year.
Buying this, they're designed to not be able to...
Correct.
Right.
So what's amazing about this economically is that they save this, and he's been saving this as far as he can count for as many as 5 generations in his own family on this land.
Wow.
So it's super acclimated to this environment, and it's going to do better in
here.
What's really strange, you know, terrain,
right.
Where it wouldn't really do the same thing if you were to take it to Iowa.
I believe that.
I started 2 years ago trying to find a better source for corn. For Macienda, the goal to preserve is for flavor, and it wasn't until we found where the flavor comes from, Mexico, that we realized that there were so many more important reasons to preserve this. You know, the two biggest ones being a direct impact on farmers. They can really celebrate what they've been known to be doing for hundreds and thousands of years. And the biodiversity. I think speaking to environmental concerns, nature is really good on its own, and we've done a great job of figuring out how to manipulate nature, but it's certainly, we're seeing the externalities of that, the impact of that in lots of ways.
Y bueno, se pretende, no, quisiéramos que todo México pudiera sembrar los maíces criollos y dejar de importar. Porque ya cada año se da la situación de que para trabajar el maíz se le invierte mucho. Y eso sale muy caro.
It's been competing with hybrids in the market. You know, this isn't a hybrid, but people think it's corn is corn.
Right.
And so it goes for 3.5 pesos, you know, which is what a hybrid you would get for. Not to mention, this is special. This is their very personal property. No one else has that seed, only this family. And so that commands a higher premium.
I think that's why we're here. That's what's important to us is to, like, help people understand that there are options and there are alternatives. The consumer dictates the market, obviously.
Right.
So there are people out there that are like, I'm willing to pay a little more because this is better for me.
Right.
There's a quality and an integrity behind the production of this.
And it's going to benefit people directly.
Exactly.
You know, that's the thing. There is no barrier.
Yeah.
You know, it's like the offtake is immediate, and the offtake is where it needs to be. And it's with the farmers and the people who are the custodians of this tradition. So you take it off. So they call it negro, right? It's black.
Yeah.
And then you take it off, and you see this amazing, you know, take off a kernel.
Yeah.
You guys
know? Más, cómalo.
Sí, mastica.
¿Comas una?
Yo ya me comí una.
Sí. Dano.
Es yo como diario.
Lo comes despacio.
No matter what anyone's philosophy is on genetically modified foods or pesticides or the risk of cancer or all of this, what is a very polemical debate today, it just tastes better.
It just tastes better.
So let's eat some food, yeah?
There's a crazy cycle of cause and effect that really links to just corn. How that becomes not only an economic issue, but then it also becomes a political issue. And it's also a health issue. And I think just being in the middle of all of it, you really start to appreciate the farmer and the environment.
I mean, I've always known that corn was a very big part of Mexican tradition, but going and seeing people who live that life and they're making not only the most of what they have, but also they're keeping it so pure. You know, you don't find that in almost anything anymore.
Wow. This is the barbecue right here. Armando and his family and taking the time to smoke a lamb, which is incredible. We shared a meal with some of the tortillas that were made from the corn grown on that farm. This was some of the best food I've ever eaten in my life. I'm not kidding you.
I'll take a piece of you. Everybody, just grab a piece. Amazing. Yo.
You know, meeting Armando and meeting his family were absolutely sweet. It makes me really sensitive to the people that are affected. There was a spirit about him and a spirit about his wife and the family, like his daughter and everything. It was just it made my heart go out to them because these are the people here. These are the ones that are affected. This is their livelihood. It's their heritage. It's their way of life. And it's not just economics for them. It's not just money. There is a quality and there is a spirit. All of that spirit is invested into, you know, growing the corn. And I think that is just really special.